Som du kan se, er musikprogrammet taget til New York. Byen, der er kendt for altid at sætte en musikalsk dagsorden. Det var her, Ramones startede punken. New York er hiphoppens mekka. Og det var her, The Strokes for et par år siden startede hele The-bølgen af rock. Vi er taget herover, fordi at vi sidste år kårede to plader som årets bedste i musikprogrammet. Det var Rufus Wainwright's 1-2 og Antony and the Johnsons plade. Og vi er taget herover for at besøge miljøet og se på scenen rundt om de her to musikere. Og meget passende, så vi har sat programmet i gang her på toppen af Chelsea Hotel, hvor Rufus Wainwright boede i halvandet år.
Say when. Welcome to New York. I'm New York. Even though I don't live there anymore, I wish that I could welcome you in style. But here I am, on Baby D. So here I am, welcoming to New York. Say when. And that's the New York that I love most.
Say when again. I love it when you say when.
It's a city of many, 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 many worlds, like the world of Antony and Rufus and all these people, is fucking huge. So I'm inviting you to like take a little peek. So say when again. What do you want me to say now?
There's sort of a scene and a following behind artists like Rufus.
No, when I started my career, I was very lonely, both in my life and in my art. There's a moment I've been saving, the kind of crucifix around this much. And now I'm so happy because there is this movement.
I spent my life telling people about Antony and how they had to come to the show.
You are my sister.
Now he's almost a household name.
And I've met a lot of this new generation of musicians who've really inspired me and kind of sort of picked me up in a way, kind of breathed a whole new life into the city.
The future for this scene, I think it's good.
Well, we're just a bunch of fags, I guess, who want to, you know, get laid. For me, it was really near the end. I mean, I had a great time for like 10 years, really. I had this vision that the greatest orgasm in the world would be to die. I went out every night, drove drunk, loved driving drunk. That was my favorite. And, you know, was skinny and had bleeding gums and thought that was sexy. And that was fine for a while, but really the last 2 years, I realized that, you know, do I really want to die of this? Is this, you know, is this the end? And then about a day later, I really crashed from where I was, and I went blind for a couple of hours. I was crying uncontrollably, and I almost lost my mind. Like I felt this depression. I experienced like an honest sort of nervous breakdown. I've always felt this strong need to write about what's going on in my life and about what is truthful to me.
Have you read The Latest Out?
I'd love to read The Latest Out.
Where's Babs? Where'd she go?
Are you a Barbra Streisand fan?
Oh, sure.
But not like a
Barbra Streisand. My sister.
Hi.
Hey, gorgeous.
Hey. Whoa. Okay. I'm excited. exhausted. I'm fine now.
Okay, we'll hear. Okay, we'll have a great show.
I will. Right?
Good show. Huh?
You look fabulous.
You look amazing. You look very Scandinavian.
Bye. There you go.
So it's proof. We're friends. We know each other.
This is an incredible room.
Right behind me is the Pyramid Club, which was for many years a very important venue for the gay scene. And actually, Antony started performing with his ensemble, the Black Lips, here at the Pyramid Club. And this is sort of like where Antony first began to develop an audience for his work. And I know it doesn't look like much, but on a Saturday night, you'll see a lot of interesting